this is a technology that I learned about because I'm curious. I'm not a firefighter. It was developed serendipitously, and you are about to see this car be put out in a few seconds with 5 liters of water, plain water, that's a little more than a gallon. So if this video starts, there we go. Oh, hello.
Oh no!
Buffering.
Well, we missed the exciting part, but there you go. It's basically almost out already.
Wow.
And so they needed ways to cut holes in roofs to ventilate, and they said, well, what about a water jet cutter? And they found that it worked to cut holes, but by the time the hole was made, the fire in the roof was out. And they said, how does that happen? So they investigated, and they developed this thing, which basically shoots 3,000 PSI water, 15 gallons a minute, 60 liters. And what happens is the water stream breaks up into droplets so small they hang in the air and they poison the fire. This is an actual building that was actually on fire. The flame was in the attic for 30 minutes. The roof was metal, so it didn't actually break through and ventilate itself, or the story would have been different. But basically, all the apartments under this roof, 160-foot long roof, with no fire breaks, extinguished with one of these things at 15 gallons a minute. By the time they cut the roof open, the fire was out.
Wow.
Yeah, and there would have been very little or no water damage to the apartments underneath. You can see how hot it got, and basically this building would have been a goner with conventional technology. They would have been fighting it for hours and it would have burned to the ground. But yeah. So this is 10 gallons per minute. You can see how big the flame was. 15 seconds is just a little bit limiting here. But you can see how quickly this one person with 10 gallons a minute is knocking down that fire. Okay, a little bit of science, which is flame uses up oxygen in a confined volume. If you get it hot, it'll burn with low oxygen, but if you can then cool it down, the fire will go out. Also, very small fog droplets absorb heat, so they get in between the fire and the fire. So that's basically how it works. This lets you go from the outside of a compartment that's burning, cut a teeny little hole in it, water jet, blast water in. The heat stays up, so anyone lying on the floor is still safe. Now look at... damn. basically, the fire just vanished when the fog hit it.
Whoa.
Yeah. The fire cannot survive in that atmosphere. This is a public service announcement. The fire alarm went off here in the hall, and in the next 15 seconds, the room becomes unsurvivable. So when they tell you to buy lots and lots of fire alarms, they mean it. Okay, back to this thing. It's useful in high rises. 3,000 PSI loses less than 10% on a 50-story building. And if you have a small apartment that is basically closed up, this can put the fire out by itself. This is a robot that carrying one of these things because it is so lightweight. It can put out flame in thatched roofs. It can put out flame underground, railroad cars, shipping containers. Very useful in limited water situations. This is a mistake because it was supposed to show a different thing of how quickly they can get it out of the van. Basically, they open the door, push one button, and unreel it. Now, here you would not want to use it because one room in flashover can just about overpower it, and here you have basically the whole house. So you'd need more water for this scenario. And it works best if there's low airflow. So why do we not have this all over the US and fire departments everywhere? Well, I talked to some firefighters and they said, oh, there's too much clutter and too much fuel load, and you need to basically drown it with water, and the fog won't work. Well, I have reason to doubt that. Ask me about it later. This was an actual comment on an actual firefighting forum in the only thread on this technology. So maybe it's not invented here. Maybe it's, oh, we're too macho to use tools that work. This is another building. Flame in the attic, and the building was basically saved. With very little water damage, which they attributed to using a different tool early on, a more conventional one. So there you go.
Wow. So just for clarification, the water jet itself creates the hole that it then blows the fog and water into.
Yeah, something I didn't have time to say is they can mix abrasive in with the water stream to cut the hole, and then they cut off the abrasive and just blast the water in, and the water, a water stream at 3,000 psi will break up into droplets fine enough to just hang in the air, go around corners, infiltrate wherever the fire is sucking. In the first one, the 160-foot long roof, the thing will only shoot about 50 feet, and it was put in at the side opposite the fire, and yet it put out the fire.
Hmm. Purposely put in the side opposite the fire?
I don't know why, maybe better access, because they had to put it on a lift to get it up to the attic level.
Yeah. Would it be useful for other kinds of fires, or like multiple, like, so like electrical fires or like gas, oil kinds of fires, or is this mostly like a household kind of?
Good question. Since it is a solid stream, you wouldn't want to use it directly on an electrical fire.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what would happen if you shot it off to the side and let the mist drift in.
Yeah.
That would be one for trained professionals, not for me to give an opinion.
That's just fair.
As far as oils, with the right additive, it would probably work very well. Yeah.
So if I'm in a burning building and there's a firefighter on the other side of the wall with one of these, what do I need to know?
Basically, if you're in a burning building and the firefighter has had time to arrive, you are on the floor. You're either unconscious or crawling trying to save yourself. The firefighter knows that and would shoot it in fairly high and at an upward angle. Once it gets in the building, that massive amount of radiant heat from the smoke overhead starts to dissipate. And the heat stays stratified. They actually did a study of what happens when you shoot this into a container with lots of hot smoke in it. And basically, it stays stratified and it cools down.
Hmm.
So it would only be good for you. Yeah.
There's a lot of law in this country about putting in sprinkler systems. Is that something that has been tried with ultra-high pressure?
Yes. So normal sprinklers basically just drown the fire, and that's great if you have enough water supply and if you don't mind getting massive amounts of water everywhere. An ultra-high pressure sprinkler, they're used on cruise ships, for example. So yes, this is something that's been tried and is in use. But of course, in a ship, you don't want to flood a room high up on the ship if the ship goes like that.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Are there people that are, like, I know you put up that one thing from the firefighting forum, which
yeah.
is not
someone
very
else,
heartbeat.
By the way, called him an idiot.
Good, I'm glad to hear that. Are there people in the United States that are working to get that here?
Yeah, there are a few of them. The fire department that I talked to, which was down in Santa Clara, they actually have something of this type, and they basically don't use it often because they basically don't believe it'll work. From the firefighter I talked to, I basically just showed up there and said, "Hi, I heard about this technology. I'm curious about it. What can you tell me?" They said, "Oh, that's a cutting extinguisher. We have one, but yeah, we don't use it because American fuel loads are too high."
Mm.
So again, if you have like the front door open and flame pouring out, then yeah, it would help at best. But if the house is still closed up and there's just smoke pouring out the eaves, that's perfect.
So
your hand up for a while.
I was just wondering, is the distinction between like ultra high pressure, is that because it's turning into droplets? Because it's so.
Yeah, so there's high pressure, which is maybe like 200 psi instead of 50, or yeah, I think 200 is considered high. Ultra high is in the thousands. And yeah, it does make smaller droplets. There's things called fog nozzles that they've been using for a long time. Basically, that just produces a spray of heavy drops that hit everything and fall down. One really nice thing about this is minimal runoff, thus minimal pollution. Yeah.
So the pictures you're describing, it's easily accessible, rather lightweight, doesn't use much water. So the Santa Clara Fire Department that has this thing but doesn't think it's going to work, why not just stick it in the truck and bring it and try it? Like,
Good question. Good question. Yeah, you can put it and its water supply for 10 minutes in a van. Why not?
What's its pump system look like?
The pump is pretty heavy duty. A pressure washer will have a motor this big to pump like 2 or 4 gallons a minute. This pump's 15. So it is truck mounted, but it, pickup truck or van. And I don't have a picture of the system there in the presentation. It's easy to Google.
Yeah. I mean, I have a water jet at work, so I pretty much.
Okay.
Noise is a question. I'm wondering if you ran into anything about noise, mm-hmm. because water jets out of water are loud as shit.
I've heard them. I used to be a tech shop member.
Yeah.
I mean, in an emergency situation,
right.
in that context, it's not too loud.
Yeah, I mean.
I mean, there's a lot of other loud sounds.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did you mention where these are popular?
Europe.
Okay.
That's where it was developed, and they've adopted it, I think, a lot more than we have here.
Yeah. It's just to point something out. There is something that a pretty big difference between European fire departments and American fire departments is the size of the trucks.
Uh-huh.
They have to navigate on European streets,
mm-hmm.
while here streets are actually as wide as they are, precisely because of fire trucks.
Yeah.
That's
yes.
the reason there aren't small roads here.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that may have lots of.
That may have something to do with it, yes. But the kinds of fires that this is useful on happen both places.
Yeah, yeah.
And when a fire truck rolls up, the first thing they do is hit the hydrant, which takes 60 seconds, during which the fire quadruples in size.
Yeah, you could easily carry a water supply on board.
Yes.
It would be something that you could use immediately.
Yes. Yeah.
What would be the possible like effect or application on things like wildfires?
Oh, the pallet demo that I showed, that was a unit designed specifically for wildfires. So, and you saw what it did there and on the smaller stack of crates. I would expect it to be very effective. And use a tenth of the water, basically, because all the water goes into fighting the fire instead of landing and running off.
I guess then I'm left with the question of, like, considering that we've had wildfires up and down the coast, like, why isn't this in use?
That's a really good question.
Pussies.
I don't know. Yeah. and I will
it
say...
It sounds like, what's the price, what's the cost of this equipment?
On the scale of firefighting equipment, I think it's modest. On the scale of out-of-pocket, it's, I think 10,000 or 20,000 for a unit, if I remember right.
Which is
ignorance is
so like a neighborhood.
Yeah, it was actually used in a joint exercise in the LA area. So it's not that they're completely unaware, and it got good reviews. They were like, "Wow, this feels like a much heavier hose." I mean, in terms of its fire putting out.
They should just print those T-shirts. That's South America. This is a good hose.
Yeah.
That's not a hose.
I have two questions.
Yeah.
The first one is, everybody seems to be interested in why aren't we using this. Do you know anywhere that people could write to, anybody we could go to and say, hey, there's this thing, I wonder if you use it, and if not, could you use it? And second, I'm curious how you became interested in this.
Well, basically I'm interested in how things work, which includes how things break. And when I realized a few years ago that YouTube had firefighting videos from actual firefighters, and some of them were even instructional, I was like, cool.
Yeah.
And then I started reading the comments, and some of them said, hey, if this was Europe, this fire would have been out much faster, because they would have used a Cobra cold cut thing. And I said, huh, Cobra cold cut. Google, tell me about that. Oh, whoa. That's cool.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. How come we're not using that? So. Tradition!
Yes.
Side note, then you could have a backyard water jet. Tree trimming would be great.
Yeah, what happens if you get in the way of one
huh?
of those? What happens if like a body gets in the way of one of those?
It's
depends on the pressure.
Yeah.
Depends on the pressure and whether there's abrasive in the stream. There's one of these that is at 2,000 PSI, no abrasive, and a fireman's coat will turn it. So you can be shot with it and not hurt. As long as it hits you in the heavy canvas. 3,000 PSI with abrasive, it would do you a lot of damage. But as I say, if you're in the fire compartment, you're on the floor anyway. Either because you put yourself there or because you inhaled smoke and fainted.
Huh.
Yeah.
Is abrasive, is it just like ground up something that's put in the stream, or what is it made of?
traditionally it's garnet. If
likely it's garnet. Garnet's a good one.
Is it a powder? Is it in granular form?
Yeah,
it's sand,
it's dusty.
Essentially.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a very fine sand.
Yeah.
Diamonds.
Sharp-edged dust. If we ever
yeah.
go to the moon, that stuff would make great abrasive.
Yeah.
Except it would probably wear out the nozzle too fast.
That's when you use diamonds.
The moon? Because the moon dust has been pulverized for billions of years and never weathered. It is very, very, very sharp.
Oh.
Well. Future talk, I'm sensing.
Yes.
Not to colonize the moon before Mars. No. There's room for both. Moon and Mars. I'm sure we'll get to both places, assuming our government holds together long enough.
That's a big
mm. Future talk for mm. someone else.
Yeah, how many years down the line?
Depends if you think Elon Musk is calculating in Earth years or Mars years.
Okay, one more question?
Yeah.
Do you know of any other fire departments besides, you said San Jose, is that what you said?
Santa Clara.
Santa Clara.
I mean, I'm sure there are. I don't know specifically which ones.
So you don't know of any cities in the U.S. that are using it?
I don't know where it would be policy. If anywhere, and of course having it is not the same as using it regularly.
It seems like car fires, it's just like that's the easiest thing to just be able
yeah.
to do.
Car fires would be nice.
Because you could have that in the back of an SUV, like on the side of a highway, where are you tying into? You got to get a water truck out there to put out.
Yeah.
You don't need that much water.
Yeah.
Mm. Showers
are
burning there?
You don't want the outside layers of your skin as well?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
fine.
Yeah.
No biggie.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah.